Everybody, in this video we're going to be covering an introduction to the Bohr model, photon absorption and emission, the emission spectrum, a quiz, and a working example. So let's get started. So now let's get into the Bohr model. So the Bohr model is a planetary model in which the negatively charged electrons orbit a small positively charged nucleus similar to the planets orbiting the Sun. So if this were my nucleus, then according to the Bohr model, these would be all the orbits of the electrons. So the main parts of the Bohr model were that electrons move in definite orbits around the nucleus, similar to how planets orbit the Sun. These orbits are located at a certain distance from the nucleus, and they have certain energy levels. So if I took this first one, this would be at n equals 1. And it would have energy level 1. The second one would be at n equals 2, and it would have energy level 2. So energy levels are similar to the steps on a ladder, gradual, and an electron can only be at one given step at any given time. So orbits closer to the nucleus are lower in energy. So at n equals 1, at energy level 1, it doesn't have as much energy as energy level 2 at n equals 2. So the other main part of the Bohr model is that electrons can move from one energy level to another by absorbing or emitting energy. So if this is my electron, so this electron is at n equals 1. If I had a photon come in, the electron could absorb the photon's energy and move up a level, and it would go to a more excited energy level because it has more energy. If an electron emits a photon, that means it would go down an energy level, and then once it comes down, it's going to emit a photon back out. So all this talk about photons, now let's see what a photon actually is. So a photon is a particle representing a quantum of light or other electromagnetic radiation. A photon carries energy proportional to the radiation frequency but has zero rest mass, which is actually quite interesting. So if you're confused about what a quantum is, in physics, a quantum is just the minimum amount of any physical entity involved in an interaction. So now let's go over photon absorption. So photon absorption is just if a photon hits an atom and the energy levels of the photon is the same as the gap between two electron energy levels in the atom, then the electron in the lower energy level can absorb the photon and jump to the higher energy level, just like I explained above. Note, when light shines on a metal, electrons can be ejected off the surface of the metal in a phenomenon known as photoelectric effect. So what's happening is that instead of just boosting the electron to a higher energy level, it's kicking the electron out of the atom entirely. So what that's doing is it's creating moving electrons, and moving electrons is the very definition of electricity. This is the same basic process of how our solar panels work, and it's known as the photoelectric effect. This process is also often referred to as photoemission, and the electrons that are ejected from the metal are called photoelectrons. So now I'm just going to quickly explain this image on the right. So this image is supposed to be depicting photons traveling in the form of electromagnetic waves, light, UV, and gamma rays, supposedly coming from the sun. I say supposedly because to me this kind of looks like a bunch of fishes on fire falling into the atmosphere, but still. So now let's go quickly read on emission. So emission is the other process I explained where the electron is moving down an energy level, then emitting a photon. So the photon is emitted with the electron moving from a higher energy level to a lower energy level. The energy of the photon is the exact energy that is lost by the electron moving to its lower energy level, because as we know, energy can't be destroyed nor can be created. So now if we go down to this picture, it actually explains quite a bit about absorption and emission. So one thing to note is this photon has a higher frequency than this photon. And this photon, the one with the more frequency, is giving more energy to the electron and is moving it two energy levels up. The one with the lower frequency is only moving the electron one energy level up. And the reason for this is a photon, the energy a photon carries is proportional to its radiation frequency. So what that means is this photon with a higher frequency is giving more energy to this electron, allowing it to move more energy levels than the other photon. And a similar case, but in reverse, is going on for emission. So here, this electron is moving down two energy levels. So it releases a photon with more energy and more frequency, like that. But this electron over here only moves down one energy level. So it releases a photon with less energy, the amount of energy that they released. So now let's cover the emission spectrum of hydrogen. So the light emitted by hydrogen atoms is red because of its four characteristic lines. The most intense line in its spectrum is the red portion of the visible spectrum at 656 nanometers. Let me explain a little bit why. So hydrogen is the simplest atom, just like its energy levels. When its only electron is excited to higher states, it can fall back to lower energy levels to emit photons with varying energies, as we can see in this diagram. So when it falls from the fifth to the second, this one over here, from the fifth to the second, it emits this bluish thing. From the fourth to the second, this tealish thing. And from the third to the second, this reddish color. It was observed if an electron falls from the third level to the second level, red light is released, and it is the most visible portion of the hydrogen spectrum, just like we saw before. So the only logical conclusion we can really make from this is if the hydrogen electron likes to come to the third and then back to the second a lot, because its most visible light is this red color, and that can only occur from the third level dropping to the second level. Now let's take a look at this diagram over here on the right. And this actually does a pretty good job at explaining everything. So, as you'll notice, these three emission patterns over here all produce visible light, and they all fall from a higher energy level to the second energy level. When something like this happens, it's known as a Balmer series. And that is when an electron falls from a higher energy level to the second energy level. There's also two other series of note. One is known as the Lyman series. So these, producing ultraviolet light, are all good examples of a Lyman series. So a Lyman series is just, as you might have guessed, when an electron falls from a higher energy level to the first energy level, like shown here. They fall from a higher energy level to the first. There's one more series, and that's known as a Paschen series. And that isn't actually listed on this diagram, but a Paschen series is when an electron falls from a higher energy level to the third energy level. Like that. So those events are known as a Paschen series. So note, energy spectrums for every element is different, just like the energy levels between their electrons. So for every different kind of atom, all these energy levels, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, has a different gap of energy between them. So now we've seen about how different emission spectrums emit different nanometers of light. So now let's see about how to calculate it. So this is the Rydberg formula. So the Rydberg formula is a mathematical formula used to predict the wavelength of light resulting from an electron moving between energy levels of an atom. When an electron changes from one atomic orbital to another, the electron's energy changes. So let's look at a formula. So this is Rydberg's formula to calculate wavelength over here. So this is solving for 1 over lambda, lambda being the wavelength. So right now I'm talking about wavelength, but everywhere else I was talking about frequency, the frequency of photons. So lambda is equal to 1 over the frequency. So the formula reads 1 over lambda, or the wavelength, is equal to Rydberg's constant for wavelengths, which has a value of 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7, multiplied by the inverse of the lower energy level squared minus the inverse of the higher energy level squared, and that is equal to 1 over lambda. So if we were to calculate for a hydrogen atom falling from the third energy level to the second energy level, so that would be 1 over lambda, or the wavelength, is equal to 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7 multiplied by 1 divided by 2 to the power of 2, which is 4, minus 1 divided by 3 to the power of 2, which is 9. And this is equal to 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7 times 5 over 36. And this is equal to 1523611, so 1,523,611. So this number here is just 1 over the wavelength. If we want to solve for the wavelength, then we would take its inverse. And if you took the inverse of 1,523,611, you would get 656 nanometers, which is a red color. And if we look over here, from the third level to the second level, it outputs 656 nanometers. So that gives a reason of why we see red as the most prominent emitted wavelength on the hydrogen spectrum. And now we have a change in energy Rydberg's formula. The first one is for wavelength. This one is for change in energy. So the change in energy is equal to minus Rydberg's constant for change in energy. And it has a value of 2.18 times 10 to the power of negative 18. And it's multiplied by the inverse of the lower energy level squared minus the inverse of the higher energy level squared. And that would give you the change in energy. So let's get into our quiz. If you need more time, just press pause. Question 1. Bohr proposed a planetary model. True or false? The answer is true. Photons are emitted with electrons moving from a lower energy level to a higher energy level. True or false? The answer here is false. It actually happens in reverse. Question 3. Electron orbits in a Bohr model are located at a certain distance from the nucleus and have the certain energy levels. True or false? The answer is true. Question number 4. Electron orbits in a Bohr model closer to the nucleus are higher in energy. The answer is false. Light absorption is the process in which light is absorbed and converted into energy. True or false? The answer is true. Question number 6. Which is the simplest atom with the simplest energy levels? The answer is hydrogen. Question number 7. Which color is the most visible in the emission spectrum of hydrogen? The answer is red. This occurs when an electron goes from energy level 3 to energy level 2. So, red, 3 to 2. Question number 8. What is the main use of Rydberg's formula? The answer is to calculate the wavelength of light emitted from when an electron moves from a higher energy level orbit to a lower energy level orbit. So Rydberg's formula will calculate the wavelength of the photon released during emission. So now let's get into our working example. So it says, calculate the wavelength of the photon emitted when the electron moves back to the lowest energy level, Lehmann series, N1, from energy levels 2, 3, and 4. Also, in what region of the electromagnetic spectrum does it occur? So, over here, we have our Rydberg's formula. And we need to solve it where N2, the higher energy level, is 2, 3, and 4. So we need to do it 3 times, and N1 will be 1 in each of those cases. So let's get started. So this is for case 2 to 1. 1 over lambda is equal to 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7, Rydberg's constant. And this will be multiplied by the inverse of the lower energy level squared. So in this case, that's just 1 over 1 squared. Minus 1 over 2 squared. And if we solve this, this is equal to 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7 times 3/4, which is equal to 8.23 times 10 to the power of 6. So this is 1 over lambda. So if you took the inverse of this number and then converted it into nanometers, you would get that lambda is equal to 121 nanometers. And a nanometer is 10 to the power of minus 9 meters, just in case you want to do it yourself and try. Next, we have from the third level to the first. So this one would be 1 over lambda is equal to 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7 times 1 over 1 squared. That is the lower energy level, which is 1 for all of the cases. Then 1 over the higher energy level squared. In this case, we're solving for 3. So 3 squared. And if you solve this, you get 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7 multiplied by 8/9. And this is equal to 9.75 times 10 to the power of 6. So if you took this inverse and you solved for it in nanometers, you would get lambda is equal to 103 nanometers. And now for the last one, from level 4, energy level 4 to energy level 1. So this is 1 over lambda is equal to 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7 times 1 over 1 squared minus 1 over, now the higher energy level squared, so this is 4 squared, and it's equal to 1.097 times 10 to the power of 7 times 15 sixteenths. And this is equal to 1.03 times 10 to the power of 7. And if you took this inverse and you convert it into nanometers, you'd get lambda is equal to 97 nanometers. And now for the last part of the question. What region of the electromagnetic spectrum does it occur? So all of these all actually fall in the ultraviolet spectrum. The visible spectrum, what you can actually see, starts at around 400 nanometers.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please drop a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.